In this video, we are going to evaluate the definite integral. First, we're going to write down a trig identity that we're going to use. That is the sine pi minus theta. Then just equals sine theta. For convenience, we are going to write I for this integral. So here we have I equals the integral from 0 to pi, then x sine to the fourth, then dx. Then how to solve this integral? We are going to use a substitution. Because we want to use this identity, so we are going to set the t, we are going to set the x equals pi minus the angle. So pi minus, we are going to use the t for the new variable. So now let's solve for the t. So then t just equals pi minus x. Now let's figure out what is the dx? Just negative dt. So now let's figure out what is the lower and upper limits for the new variable. When x equals the lower limit, then put it here, so t equals pi. Then when x equals pi, the upper limit, put it here, so t is a zero. Okay, so now let's do the substitution. So let's continue this equal sign. So then here we have from the lower limit, there's a pi, upper limit zero. So x is here. Then sine x, then to the power 4. Then dx, negative dt. Let's simplify. First, let's swap the upper limit with the lower limit, because here we have a negative sign. So then here we just have the lower limit, upper limit. So now let's see sine. Sine pi minus t. Based on the identity here, just sine pi minus theta just equal sine theta. That's why for our case, just equal sine t. Then dt. So next, we are going to separate this integral into two parts. The first one, here just sine. Then the second integral, here that's t and sine. So now let's take a close look at the second integral. So inside the integral, that's a variable times sine to the fourth. Then compare with the original integral. They are exactly the same. So that's why, so we have I equals this part. But this part here, that's just I. So that means we have I equals the new integral. So here just sine to the fourth. So then here just I. Then solve for I. So both sides plus I, that's 2i. Then both sides divided by 2. So then we have I equals half pi. Then this new integral. So now let's look back. The reason at the beginning we set x equals to pi minus t, just so we can get to this point. So then we have a new integral. Comparing to the original one, so this one is easier. Because here is the t times sine to the fourth, but here no variable before sine. So this one is easier. How to solve this one? So we need to reduce the power. Because sine to the fourth is equals to sine squared then squared. So we're going to use a double angle formula. So then here is the formula. So cosine 2 theta just equals 1 minus 2 sine. We want to involve sine. 2 sine squared. So then solve for sine squared. So then here we have sine squared equals to 1 minus cosine, double angle, then divide by 2. So now we're going to apply this formula to x squared. So now let's continue to this this equal sign. So then here we have then use a formula. So here we have a 1 minus cosine, the double angle, then here square, and dt. So this one is a t. Okay, so then take out the 1 half squared. Then here's a 1 fourth. Then expand the inside part. That's 1 minus 2 cosine 2t. Then plus cosine 2t squared. So next, we are going to separate this integral into 3 parts. So let's see the first one, just dt. This is the second one. We take a negative 2 outside. Here just cosine 2t dt. Then the last one, that's cosine squared. Okay, so now let's work on each integral. So this one just pi. So the second one, so inside is a cosine. So then here just sine 2t, then divide by 2, evaluated from 0 to pi. Then this one, we cannot get the answer right away. So here, so let's rewrite it. We still need to do some work for this part. Okay, so now let's see, what's this part? Because if we put a pi here, sine 2 pi, that's a 0. Then put a 0 here, sine 0 is a 0. So that's why, so this part, just 0. So now we need to work on this part. So it's the same thing, we need to reduce the power. But then we are going to use the double angle formula again, but this time involving cosine squared. So then here is a double angle formula for cosine. But involving cosine squared, that's a 2 cosine squared minus 1. Then solve for cosine squared. So then here we have cosine squared, then here 1 plus cosine, the double angle, then divide by 2. Okay, so we're going to apply this formula to here. Let's continue this equal sign. Okay, so here, then we have pi over 8, then this part just is 0. Okay, so now let's see the last part here, just this one. Use a formula, that's 1 plus cosine 2 theta. So for our case, the theta is 2t, so here that's 2t. Okay, so then divided by 2, then dt. Okay, so then we are going to separate the integral into 2 parts. We cut from here. So then take out 1 half outside to this first integral. Then the second one. So here's a cosine 4t, then dt. Okay, so now let's, here's a pi. Okay, so then here 就是 one half pi. Then for this one, so inside is a cosine. So then here is your sine 40 divided by 4, evaluated from 0 to pi. Okay, so now let's see what's this part. So here, put a pi inside, that's a sine 4 pi, that's a 0. Put a 0 here, sine 0 is a 0. So that's why, so this part is a 0. So 0. So then here we have pi over 8. So then the inside part combined is 2, that's 3 over 2, then times pi. Then put them together. That's a 3 on top, the bottom 16, then here pi squared. So that's why 3 over 16 pi squared is the final answer for this integral. Thanks for watching.